It's really lovely to be here with you. My name is Natálie. I'm a student at the Department of Information Science and Library Studies, and I would like to walk you through our student project that we did in Service Design Workshop. That's like a practical class, usually focused on a more traditional frameworks. But in autumn, we try to do something different. We try to like dive in the transition design projects. So my team consisted of five students and our mentor, Teresa, who will talk to you later in the afternoon. And our topic was urban green spaces. Naturally, we were interested in many different aspects of the topic, like whether people feel some kind of ownership towards public spaces, or, you know, how about the developers and planners. So we did an initial research to try to find what we really want to focus on. So these are very simplified some key findings. We found out, based on some analyses and interviews, about like the constant pressure that green spaces face in the urban context. We found out about green projects that are based more on populism, not an expertise, so they are not very sustainable. And we also found out about places that may seem useless to us because they are unmaintained, for example, but they are really important to like other people, like people without housing, or they are important to an entire ecosystem. We also began to be really interested in citizen participation, because, you know, that's a topic that's very sexy in Czech cities, Czech towns, but there are still many limits. Like diverse needs are not very reflected. People are not encouraged to take part. And yeah, that's it. So these are our stakeholders. So we really wanted to emphasize, for instance, people with disabilities or mobility issues and people without housing, for whom green spaces are very important, yet a very challenging territory. And so after our analysis mapping, we tried to list for each of our stakeholders some fears and hopes that they might feel in the present. And based on that, we thought about future. We tried to envision like life of these stakeholders where that fears are overcome and those hopes are fulfilled. So we did this for all of our stakeholders. And based on that, we were able to come back to the present and to propose some solutions that would lead to that future. So we, for instance, wanted to educate kids to let them take care of an actual urban green space and let them experience that they can have an impact on that green space. We wanted, obviously, to do something with that participation and to invite like more diverse groups of people to that dialogue. And our third project was all about advocating nature's needs and just sending the message that nature in cities needs more peace and more space, let's say. And like merging all the values and ideas from these projects really arrived us at a vision of empathic city that listens to like its diverse inhabitants of diverse backgrounds, but also to its non-human actors. So at the end of the project, we really wanted to design an actual intervention. So we used theory of change for that. We wrote down again our default problem and our long-term change, and we asked ourselves like, how do we get from where we began to where we want to be? And what really made sense to us was this idea of a platform that connects all of our stakeholders, like citizens, experts, nature, municipality. And this platform would be an actual partner of the town where it operates, but it would operate like very differently. It would operate with that long-term vision in mind, like as opposed to institutions that are forced to solve problems here and now. So it would work like slowly and patiently, with the focus on ensuring that diverse participation based on empathy, social learning, and representing like non-human actors. So that was basically our project. We did this like wonderful artifact at the end. It's like a fun activity that represents like a perfect town where the platform works and everything's just wonderful. And I have just like 5 takeaways for you at the end. So as we just talked about, it really takes time to shift like your mindset to that transition design approach. We had an entire semester to do this project, which like really helped, I think. Then like designing a transition is very much about sharing and reflecting. So sometimes we just met, we wanted to design something, but instead we just talked about what we find important, what we want to keep in the future. And that was very different from what I've encountered at like human-centered projects, where the scope of the debates was just very different. But insights for people who challenged our views shaped our project. So during interviews, we talked to developers or architects, for instance, who talked a lot about how things are now and like what they are not happy about, for instance. But then we talked to a sociologist, for example, who offered a very different, much more critical perspective and really uncovered different layers of like practices that we take for granted, I guess. And that was really, really extremely helpful for that vision in part, for instance. Transition design is challenging in a good way. I think Nick summed it up like much better than I would do. And like this project really changed how we see and want to do design. I think we will never, like none of us will ever come back to a purely like human-centered approach. And for example, one of my friends from the project, this was like her first design experience like ever. And to her, transition design felt very natural and it just made sense to her. And this is how she wants to like keep doing design. And I think that really says a lot about transition design. So thank you, and special thanks to our mentor.
Okay.
I'm wondering if such practice or course can be as well part maybe of some municipality project, or not maybe just at the university, but if you see some way how to advocate the way, how to as well promote it in different contexts, maybe more powerful in some sense.
Mm-hmm. Like you mean whether we could do something different, something similar in a different setting?
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, like I think, like I believe that what we ended up with is really like a little bit unrealistic and very huge. So perhaps now like taking little steps ahead in a different setting than like a class would be a way to go, I believe. Okay.
Thank you. Next questions.
No.